Hello and welcome to my AgroDruid guide. So why do you want to play AgroDruid? Well, in the current meta, I think it's a very strong deck. If you want to climb the ladder very fast, this might be a deck for you. So the advantages of playing AgroDruid is you have very quick matches and you have a pretty solid win rate against all the popular decks at the moment. I reached a legend as one of the first players on the European server in the February season 2016, and I reached rank 10 legend on the 5th of February, actually. So yeah, if you want to play AgroDruid, to try AgroDruid, then I recommend watching this guide. So let's go over the options here. So this is the list I'm currently using. I think it's the best list, obviously, and but there's some choices here which you can change. So one common choice is Sir Finlay in AgroDruid. Usually this is taken instead of a leper gnome. I don't really like that card too much in AgroDruid because I think the hero power of the druid is already one of the best, and so the only thing better would be sometimes Hunter and sometimes Warlock, and you take the risk of getting something useless like Shaman or like Paladin or something not useless but not as strong as Druid. So I think taking the risk and giving up the Leper Gnome damage, which is usually 2 or 4 damage, for a 1/3 minion who does like 1 or 2 damage. And you have a chance of getting a hero power which is slightly better than Druid, but also you have a chance of getting a worse one. So here's the Sir Finlay card if you want to look at it. All right, other options. So the two drops, I think Knifejugger is the strongest by far, but you need to remember that the Knifejugger is not often, or like, it can be played as a true drop, but also one of its strength is later on. Like for example, with 5 mana, if you do like Juggler, you play Living Roots for 2/1s, and you play Thanatos, for example, and you get 3 juggles, potentially sniping an opponent minion. That's really strong synergy. Or for example, you play Knife Juggler, you play Force of Nature. That's also 3 juggles, and then you can kind of go from there. So yeah, Thanatos is also really strong. Druid of the Saber is not extremely strong on its own. It has some synergies with stealth and like Savage Roar the next turn, or you can also use it as a charge and trade for example for threatening enemy minion like enemy Knife Juggler or Sorcerer's Apprentice, for example. So I like that card, but there's other options. For example, this card can be used, Flame Juggler. It's just a personal preference thing. Yeah. So the rest is pretty standard. Okay, the Argent Horse Rider. There's a common card which is used instead of this. This is, I'm not sure if other players use it, but I think I'm the first one to popularize this in AgroDruid. The card usually used in AgroDruid in the 3 mana spot is the Beast. What is card? Yeah, the Mounted Raptor. And I personally like the Horse Rider much more because the Mounted Raptor is sort of a slow card. It's a card that has a lot of value because you get the free 2 and you get the random 1 drop, which can be like something reasonably good. Like the best would be Flame Imp for 3/2 stats, or like the Shaman card, which is 3/1 and has Wind Fury, for example, or like a Zombie Shower or something. But it doesn't get the effect immediately. And with Aggro Druid, you often need the effect immediately. You need the damage immediately, since this deck is so much about bursting and having the opponent at low life, but your hand is empty, and you need to top deck that damage to win. For this reason, I like the horse, right? It has some synergies. For example, you have the seven draw in the hand, right? And you're waiting to use it, and you have a minion left over, and then you top deck the Argent Horse Rider. That's 4 damage right there, and the mounted raptor is nothing. Yeah, it's 0 damage on this turn you play it. Okay, so other cards. I think the Fel River is the core of the deck. If you cannot afford to craft the Fel River, then you cannot play this deck. That's one of the win conditions also, the Fel River. In a lot of matchups, especially ones that have limited or no answers to a big minion, innovating a Fel River on turn 2 or 3 is just it's just gonna win the game immediately. All right, the boom is a bit slow, but again, probably needed just to have more threats. Okay, so for 4 mana, there's an interesting card which is also quite common in this deck, which is the Savage Combatant. I think this card is certainly an option. You can replace, for example, a Pilot of Treader with it, or Druid of the Claw with it. But I like the other, like I'm playing the other 2 minions, so I think that the Savage Combatant is to meant to be used as a well, 6 mana drop actually, because the minion itself with the 5/4 stats and 4 mana, it's okay, but it's easily removed. By the time the opponent has 4 or 5 mana, usually you can deal with this card quite nicely. So you want to wait until 6 mana to get the immediate effect with the extra damage from the hero power. Can be quite strong, but it's a little bit slow, I think. I like playing fast with this deck especially. So that's my reason for not including this card. All right, so the general playstyle and Mulligan, we go over this. I think I'm just gonna do like 2 or 3 games maybe, and explain some stuff as we go. Let's play ranked. Quite high legend rank here, so should be good games, should be strong opponents. So what you want to watch out for the Mulligans is you want a strong curve in the early game. You want to play as strong of a board early on as you can, since that's the damage which will then set up for the lethal. So of these cards, I don't like any against Warlock, and against any class I would always throw away all three cards here, because you need a 1-drop, a 2-drop, or at least a 2-drop, and have a good chance of an innovate for a strong starting hand. That's better, but not ideal. Like the Living Roots is a good 1-drop, but you want to play something on every turn. Like now I'm playing the Living Roots, but turn 2 is weak. Yeah. So something like a innovate would be great. And okay, so now I can't play anything. Since he didn't play anything on his turn 1, despite him having the coin, I expect him to be like some control Reno Warlock, which is something to consider. So he doesn't do anything again. My hand is really slow, but against the Reno, that's all right. That's not as bad as it looks. Since we do have the Force of Nature Savage Rock combo, we can do some pretty good burst, especially if we get an innovate. So, okay. So now at least we have something to play with the Shredder here. So that's nice. This is like not the strongest curve, but like it's okay curve, but it's slow. It's slow as hell. So we have a couple of options here. We can actually like we can Fel River, or we can Druid of the Claw. I think the Druid of the Claw is a bit better here, since he has a lot of cards in hand. It's quite likely he will have an answer for the Fel River, and the Druid of the Claw is not as easily answered. Probably gonna play him in taunt mode, and trading for the true freeze is alright. Since we need, just looking at our hand, we need probably the combo to clear to kill him. Putting him low doesn't really matter against this type of deck because they run a lot of healing, and so putting him low won't accomplish anything. We need to finish him off with some burst. So that's why we need to fight for the board. The swipe is good here, it clears the board, so we will do that probably. Yeah. And then play the hero power over the Nasus, since we want to protect our Shredder, we want him to force some answer for this. So he's playing the Sludge Pinch, and okay, that's fine. That's the best minion to get, or one of the best. Small issue, like, I will go for Dr. Boom here, but we run into issues if he has a Mind Control deck, which is a quite popular card. But we don't have any other options here, really. Like, the Nasus and the Fel River is just much weaker. Because the boom bots are so strong in this case, since they will kill oftentimes they will kill minions. Obviously not this time, but you get the point. So now we set up a win next turn. The way to do this is we kill the taunt off, and we put him to 14. This forces him to heal, or he's dead. It's quite likely we'll have healing, but that's like all we can do to hope he doesn't have healing here. So now that he already played his Pick'em Hunter, feeling a lot better about the Fel River. So we will play the Fel River here. The question is, what do we do with the other mana? I think hero powering the 3-3 and killing it off with the hero power and the 2-1 is quite reasonable here in this situation. We play Fel River, we play Stealth, and we kill off this. Does it change much if we, for example, we hero power face, then he would be at 19. So then we would win if we cannot clear the Stealth. I think that's too optimistic, because he will have stuff like Shadow Flame, for example. And maximizing the chance that the Fel River lives is better. Or like Taunt is also quite often. An issue. So we could use one Savage Roar here and hope he doesn't have healing or taunt. But that's also, well, I think if he had another taunt, he would play it over the Shredder, I feel. So maybe we just go for it. If we save a draw here, we can put them to 14. I think that's alright. Because we have the second copy anyway. So now we bank on no heal, no taunt. He has 3 cards in the hand. No, that works. The lower tap. But he needs to find, like, next turn, same situation. The swipe. We could swap here. Just we don't have any other play really, so I'm gonna swap here. And the reason for this is that I can even kill this, but the reason for this is just to prevent some stuff like Defender of Argus from being an out for him. Yeah. That was what I was afraid of, this card. Now it's gonna be extremely hard to win. We basically we need a miracle, I guess. We have one force left, but we are out of like this is our last Savage Roar, and we need basically to win on the board again, and then leave him with force Savage Roar, which is gonna be hard to do. He's going aggressive. That makes me think he has some kind of burst combo in the hand, but there is nothing like. The problem is we are behind in cards and we're behind the board. So the only way to win is by killing him faster than he can kill us. So the way to go about this is to just play extremely aggressive and force him to make the trades. Because if for example I kill the Emperor or something, not gonna win the game. At this point we are outvalued so heavily that we need to play really aggressive. It still won't work most of the time, but that's the only way we can win. So now he has 14 damage on the board. We have 14 life. The innovate doesn't help. We could do the combo to face just because we have the mana now, and it's possible that we, for example, we top deck the second force of nature. And that might be enough then. So he needs just one damage to kill us, which he will have like almost always. But if we start trading with his minions, there is absolutely no way we are gonna win. No way. This at least gives us some options that he doesn't have any damage, and we top deck, for example, the swipe or something, and we can win. But not gonna work out most of the time, yeah. Alright. We are still alive. I hope. Or is he just trolling us? I guess he's just trolling us. That's fine. Gonna start the second game. Hopefully, I can explain a little better about the strategy. So, the most important thing is to know the matchup. For example, against a Zoo or a Paladin, board control becomes really, really important. And against other classes, it's more about the face damage and finding the combo to win. Is it the same? That's the same guy. So we already know it's Areno. The matchup is. In itself, it's quite it's all right. Against if I didn't know it was Areno, I would keep the Keep of the Grove just to have an answer for stuff like Egg or Twilight Drake. But since he's running only one Drake, I don't think it's worth it to keep it. Just gonna keep the one drop, hope for a stronger curve, innovate, or like basically strong minions. Like this is much better. So now, options are to play coin and like. I think we should put on the pressure early. For example, coin the Nasus would be a pretty good play. It trades on board against the Dark Peddler, which is a very common one drop, a two drop, for this warlock. And also, if he dark bombs, that's fine. We have follow up with these two minions. So now, I think the correct play here is to use this Living Roots for 2 damage to kill this off, to preserve the life on Darnassus, since the mana gain is quite important. I'm gonna play the Druid of the Saber in stealth here. So now we have another options. We could trade with the 3-2 and play these two minions. That's alright. We could also swipe, but that's weaker. So I think I will go for this trade and playing the other two minions. It's a pretty reasonable board against the Hellfire. It just clears two minions, and yeah, it puts at least we have a minion left. So no reason to use the swipe. I feel we just need to go a bit slower here. So he's playing Lord Tap, that's alright. At least the Lord Tap has, like, for example in this one, in this last game where he played the Lord Tap and blocked our lethal with the combo, that was high impact Lord Tap. This is a low impact Lord Tap. It doesn't matter, I didn't want to use any spell anyway this turn. So I probably need to kill the Bran here, since if he has Healbot, that's 16 healing, that's quite a lot, and we don't have any minion to develop anyway. Well, now we have, but Swipe and Hero Power is just gonna be better against the Bran, because the Bran will, if he has, for example, Healbot, that's, I don't want to gain him gaining so much life. Alright, that's not threatening. So he's stepping to 13, so that means if we top deck Innovate, we will win straight up. So we could, for example, we could Force of Nature to the face, that we will have lethal next turn. But with the amount of healing they are running, I think that's optimistic. Just going for the minion is better, since he will have the Reno often, and or the Healbot, and if we do this play and it doesn't work, we are like in a way worse shape. Alright, so he has Defender. So now I will clear the taunt with the Defender. With the Force, just so I have lethal next turn. We clear both taunts. It doesn't matter if we take some damage here, just to have the way cleared for the next turn where we will combo. So it's the same situation again. He needs to heal or he's dead. Unfortunately, he has one spot remaining, so he can play the Healbot. Yeah. Nice. He's searching. He's searching. The Reno. So it is the aggressive version. That's not gonna be enough to kill me, I don't think. So this game works out. So that's the, like, I play a similar deck to this Warlock also, and it's quite fun. But it's a little bit inconsistent because you have only one of the good cards, like the heal, the Reno, the healbot, and if you don't have them, well, we're gonna lose. So I'm gonna wait like 30 seconds for the next game, since I want a different matchup to discuss some more strategy here. Maybe a little bit longer. So it's another Warlock. Let's hope it's a zoo, so we can get a kind of a different dynamic going. No matter what it is, these two cards are really strong. Like, even the juggler is like, this is perfect opening hand, despite for no innovate. But if you can get on the board early and do like some damage, usually this hand will do 15 damage over the first turns. So this is zoo. I think just playing the Living Roots here is the play, since the Living Roots challenge the Squire the best. If I play the Lepronome, the Squire will get more value. If I play the Juggler, I'm basically play Coin Juggler. I'm going all in on him not having Abusive Sergeant, which is certainly something to consider, but not gonna work out. So the problem here is that the Knife Jugger will most likely die, but I don't have any great other play, so I'm just gonna play the Knife Jugger and trade. Could have considered playing the Lepognom, just in Lepognom, to challenge the Spider, but I think taking the chance on the Knife Jugger is also okay. So now we are basically in trouble. The swipe would be great here. Otherwise, we will go for the Coin Keeper. I guess the Living Roots is better than the Coin Keeper. We can do this and coin the Hero Power. That we can keep on next turn, which is also nice. I would do it for damage most likely, unless he plays Nurban Egg against Sue. This is quite different from a lot of other matchups, because I feel the board control is the way to win. If you can deny them board control, that's huge. And so far this game, I'm not able to do that. But they have a lot of cards which require them to have a minion on board. If not, it's much, much weaker. So the problem is this gang boss is really strong, and I will just silence it, because I think that's more impactful than for example dealing 2 damage to the 1-1 here, since the gang boss will spawn probably 2 or 3 imps if I don't silence him. Yeah, this game looks hard if I don't draw some good answers, because this combo is basically not very useful. At least we draw something to do, killing the demon over the non-demon just for Jaraxxus synergy, or like Mal'Ganis, Mal'Ganis synergies. So I think if you have any options against Sue, you should try to get the board in hand. Doing damage to the face is not as relevant, because usually they will have cards like Defender of Argos to block your combos anyway. And 1 mana off of doing something great. I think just I need to use the Force of Nature here, not to fall too behind on the board. It sucks to give up the combo, but I think with the Dr. Boom for next turn, he will do some work, hopefully. And shutting down this board is also a real priority. And we do have one more Force of Nature in the deck, which we can draw for the burst. That was not what was planned. So now we will just hope for the best. But the first one to play the Doctor Kaboom has a pretty nice advantage. Think he should tap first to find some better options, because this is like all right, but so the question is, does he trade here? If I was him, I would trade just to not take any chance I have, like innovate combo or something to kill him, because he's so far ahead on the board that if he trades, he's gonna win like almost 100% of the time anyway, and this just gives me some options, some ways I can kill him. With my hand I cannot, but he doesn't know that. So can we even stay alive? That's 9-10. I don't think there's any way to stay alive here. Okay. I cannot kill more than one minion. Like I can kill the 8-8, but I don't have any way of killing another one. And he has 10 on board. And if even if I get the armor, I can just armor up. So to 10, and he will kill me. So that didn't work out. Well, I feel like the hand was really like slow. Not in the beginning, but then it slowed down. We got the combos pieces, but no good minions to play, and no innovate was the main thing. One thing to consider is this deck has a way better win rate if you draw the innovate in the opening hand, for example. This is just a real power play. You can win games without the innovate, but it's not as easy. For example, now the boom is a bit slow, but the innovate is nice to see, and we will certainly keep that. If we draw, for example, a Fel River, that's gonna be almost surely just the win. Like for example, great. Now we will just play the Fel River, and the only way he can stay in this game is if he has Innovate Big Game Hunter, exactly these two cards. That's the only way, because otherwise the Fel River will just do at least 16 damage, and then it's just gonna be impossible for him to combat this. So always pay attention to what is burned in your deck. For the most important stuff to consider is the combo pieces. So I think this play makes absolutely no sense at all from him, since like a common mistake I see people making against Fel River is they try to burn your card, right? But it doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter that you burn the cards if you are not able to kill the Fel River, because the game will not go long enough for me to fatigue. So it doesn't matter if the cards are burned, or like if you never burn some great cards, it still doesn't matter, because I will draw a card every turn. And it doesn't matter if the card are burned or if it's on the bottom of the deck, since you go off out of the way to innovate the keeper to do 2 damage to the Fel River with no way of killing it next turn. I think he needs like just to burn 9 cards of mine. I think that's a big mistake. I think he should not do anything. Hope he draws a Big Game Hunter, for example, so now he can innovate or corner out the Big Game Hunter, and he has a chance of winning the game. Yeah, I mean, obviously. Innovate Fel River is the strongest, one of the strongest openers you can have, and it's really powerful and very hard to deal with. This shows the power of Innovate, basically. So now against Warlock, I don't know anything about him. I don't know what type of Warlock he's playing, so I will keep the like I do have pretty pretty reasonable early game. I will keep the Keep of the Grove just because of his versatility. I can silence a Twilight Drake. I can do 2 damage to a Knife Juggler. It can silence a Nerubian Egg. So it's quite a strong card against Warlock in specific. That he plays the Abusive Sergeant on turn 1 makes me think it's more likely Sue. The Living Roots challenging the 2-1 is the best play here, I think. We can follow up with Druid of the Saber and then coin the Keeper into Keeper. Always look for a good curve. So, what do we do here? So just playing the Saber in stealth, I think, is the play. Trading with the 2-1. As I said before, against Sue, it's really, really important to have board control. I think that's the most important, in this matchup in specific. So I will go out of my way to get board control. And I will not... for example, here I will play the Keeper for 2 damage and trade. Just if I remove board, I remove options for the Sue. And it sucks, the Haunted Creeper is very difficult to remove, but they have sticky minions, that's a little bit annoying, but you should try to remove as much as possible. So I think playing the Thanatos here and the Hero Power just to remove 2 more minions is correct. This is the only matchup I don't go for, like aggressively pushing for the face if I don't have good trades. But even removing 1-1s is quite important against Sue because they run so many buff cards like Power Overwhelming, etc. So he's getting a good juggle here. he really wants to remove the Thanatos, I think, but that's a mistake, I think. The reason I say that, he should he's going out of the way to remove the Thanatos. I think that's reasonable. Do have quite a bit of options here. Can go with the Keeper. Do 2 damage to him. Play Lebanon and trade, for example, like this. Could also play just Fel River and trade. But or Druid of the Claw. I think removing more of the board is priority here and gaining more. Like, actually, now that I think about it, maybe the lower tap is also worth considering. So I think the plays are the options are between the 5 drops now. I will go with the lower tap here. Since it makes my play next turn better, I will have the option of playing the Keeper and Hero Power. And if I play Keeper now and Lepanom, I won't have any options next turn. I will need to play a 5 drop. And this way I can still have options with the Keeper. For example, if you play something which needs silencing. And this also prevents like Power Overwhelming. Or not prevents, but it makes him use the whole turn. That's quite annoying. The swipe would be great here. Don't have the swipe, but there's the swipe. Is it good enough? Probably is. We can Hero Power here first, so he gets one less. Yeah, I think that's the play. So Hero Powering here first, so he doesn't get the extra imp. So now we have quite a bit of a lead in cards, and we're still pretty healthy. So unless he has very powerful play like Dr. Boom, I think we're still quite good in this game. Doing quite well. So I want to play 2 minions here. I want to play the Lepanum plus something, and I think the Druid of the Claw is just a better choice here. To protect the Lepanum from the 1-1 or the 1-3, to trade into it, and this forces removal. If he has like Power Overwhelming, he will use it now, and then my Fel River will go unchecked, hopefully. Also, there's a risk he's running Pickham Hunter. And if I waste 5 mana on the Fell River now and he has Pickham Hunter, well, that really sucks. So we can push for damage here with, for example, Druid of the Claw, Savage Roar. I think that's probably not the way to go. Just gonna go with trade, Fell River, and Hero Power, and hope he doesn't have Pickham Hunter, because now there's no way he can remove the Fell River without Pickham Hunter. Well, I guess Doomguard trade with the Doomguard, and then he can trade with the 8/8. That's an option. So, we do have combo in hand. That's something to consider. This is interesting. So we need to play the Claw and the Keeper here. I think the Keeper doesn't have much value here. Actually, so I think I will just go for the Claw in charge mode. Trade like this. So there's two options now, right? I can play the Keeper for 2 damage here, trade and go face, or I can silence the lower tap, trade with the 2/1 and go with the 8 in the face. I think that's a bit better. If it doesn't have another taunt, that's way better. Since it sets up lethal for the combo, right? And he still needs to deal with the 8/8 too. So in this case I went aggressively. But he used a lot of taunt givers already, so even if he has another taunt giver, he still needs to deal with the 8/8, which requires both minions to trade in. So I believe that's still lethal, yeah, for sure. So, nice game, and illustrates how important board control is. I think we will do one more game for the guide. Hoping for a matchup which we didn't have yet. Perhaps, that's quite interesting. So against the Shaman, I feel it's 90% like aggro Shaman. This is just all too slow, way too slow. And we need to fight for the board and then at some point just race him down. Like, this is much better start, even though it doesn't look like it, but the Fell River really does a lot of work against Shamans. Unless they overrun me, like, basically, really quickly. So, I'm thinking about coining the Saber here, just because so I can deal with the Tunnel Drog next turn. I think that's worth it. Even though I delayed the Fell River for 1 turn, but this Tunnel Drog it can get so out of hand. And if it doesn't have an overload spell, for example, yeah, this now I can trade for it for free, which is a big deal. And I'm not gonna waste my innovate here for the Argent Horse Rider, since I will need to get out the Fell River. The fact that he's playing MechWarper makes me think he has Fell River 2 in his deck, since there would be no other reason. So no other option than to go for the Fell River here, I feel. If he has one himself, now it's only 4 mana, so he will play it now. Oh, I guess he's overloaded, he cannot. But at this point, I think it's really important just to ignore him and go for push for face damage and race him, because we are way faster than him, since we have the savage draw potential and also we have the bigger minions in general. So I think that's the reason. So he was hoping to roll high on the cracker to kill it off. So what do we do here? Probably just the horse rider. Don't see any reason to kill the totem here, or to waste 8 damage to kill the Magwarper. Not waste, but I mean to skip 8 damage to the face. Since if he plays Fel River now, like he cannot deal with the with his Fel River again. So then he will just die. Okay, so he's wasting, like, the Fel River wasting, like, 5 cards of his burn, which I'm fine with. I'm just gonna play the second Fel River. He didn't have an answer for the first one, so why would he have one now? Still, if, it doesn't matter that I discard any cards, because as long as I'm still drawing cards, it really doesn't matter. And I do have everything in the hand, which I need to win. So he's rolling 6, which is very fortunate for him. But I think at this point it doesn't really matter, since he used so much damage to kill my Fel Reavers that he's just out of damage at this point. And we will just kill him off probably really soon. So here I'm probably gonna swipe this just to be safe. And I don't have anything great to do. Anyway, let's just count quickly if the damage is enough to kill him. If we savage draw, that's 6 plus the 5 on the board, that's 11 plus the swipe, so that's 15. That's 2 damage off. I think just swiping this is safer and will win the game anyway. Will get the game anyway basically next turn or the turn after. So yeah, that's gonna be it for this guide. I hope you enjoyed the guide. If you have any like questions or criticism, I guess just let me know in the comments, and would appreciate a follow on Twitch or Twitter or Facebook or on YouTube. Links will be below. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. Take care. Goodbye.